Senator Nelson, can you elaborate on what you told my colleague Steve Bosquet yesterday about Russians being in Florida election records? Do you mean right now, or were you referring to 2016?
Right now. Senator Rubio and I have written a letter together to all 67 of the county supervisors of election. He is a member of the Intelligence Committee. I am the ranking member of the Cyber Subcommittee of the Senate Armed Services Committee. We were requested by the chairman and vice chairman of the Intelligence Committee to let the supervisors of election in Florida know that the Russians are in their records. The letter that we sent also pointed out you can have assistance to secure your records from the U.S. Department of Homeland Security free of charge. You have to reach out, and we gave them all the contact information. This is no fooling time, and that's why two senators, bipartisan, reached out to the election apparatus of Florida to let them know that the Russians are in the records, and all they have to do, if those election records are not protected, is to go in and start eliminating registered voters. And you can imagine the chaos that would occur on election day when the voters get to the polls and they say, "I'm sorry, Mr. Smith, I'm sorry, Mr. Jones, you're not registered. Well, here's my registration card. Well, I'm sorry, you're not on the registration record." You can imagine that's exactly what the Russians want to do. They want to sow chaos in our democratic institutions. And every intelligence agency in the United States government has said that they are going to try to disrupt the 2018 elections just like they did in 2016.
What do you mean by they're in the election records? What do you mean by that?
Just exactly what I said. They have already penetrated certain counties in the state, and they now have free rein to move about.
Is that public knowledge? That's the first, I believe.
We wrote this letter a month ago, of course. How many times have the intelligence community, the Director of National Intelligence, the CIA, the FBI, have said the elections are subject to the Russians trying to distort and create chaos in the 2018 elections?
Are you saying that the Florida Department of State has not asked the federal government, DHS, for help for this free service?
They are not responsible. We sent a copy of our letter to the Division of Elections. The individual election records are run by the 67 county supervisors of election, and that's why Senator Rubio and I wrote to all of them with a copy to the Division of Elections in Tallahassee.
I know this summer counties received money for cybersecurity, for election security, to beef it up because of possible problems. Do you think that's enough? I think Hillsborough received $800,000.
That was $19 million that we had appropriated, a huge amount for all the states. Florida had not drawn down its money. When we pointed that out, Florida then decided to draw it down. But that's a separate matter from what I'm talking about. Senator Rubio and I pointed out that the election supervisor needs to get in touch directly with the Department of Homeland Security, because they can come in with experts and help them secure the records from the Russians being able to do very bad things to the election records.
Have any of the 67 counties asked DHS for help that you know of?
I don't know. You will have to ask them.
Hillsborough County told us that none of their records are accessible to the internet because it's all internal.
I can't speak to that. I'm telling you what the intelligence community told Senator Rubio and me, and that's when we fired off the letter together in a bipartisan way.
So should voters be concerned?
Absolutely. Not only in Florida, but in about 20 other states, that we have been told by the FBI that the Russians are in those states.